Today we're going to look at a feature that lets you translate a website or select a text within a website with Safari on the iPad. This can be useful if you encounter content on a web page in an unfamiliar language. With Safari's Translate feature, you'll be able to translate the website or text within just a few taps. Let's see how. Now, before we dive in, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, with that out of the way, let's take a look at how we can translate websites or text within a website with Safari on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. First thing I want to mention is I am using an iPad Pro 11-inch here, along with iPad OS 18, but this is not an iPad OS 18 feature. This has been around for several years. So what I'm going to demonstrate here should work on older iPad OS versions. The way that you access it might change slightly, but for the most part, you should be able to follow along and translate websites. All right, let's see how we do this. Let's go ahead and open up Safari. When I open up Safari here, you're going to see that I'm on a web page about sports in Canada. Well, being that's in Canada, maybe I should read it in French. How can I do that? Well, the first thing that we need to do is we need to add French as a language to the iPad. We are not going to be able to translate any text, any web pages in Safari until we add a second language. So that's the first step that we have to do. So how do we do that? Well, we do this in the Settings app. So now I need to swipe up and then go over to Settings. Under Settings, what you're going to see when we go over to General here, what you're going to see when I swipe up is an option for Language and Region. This is what we need to select. This is where we can go and add our different languages, and we can add more than one. So now I tap on that. And then we go over here to add language. So I'm going to add French, and let's just go and add Spanish as a second language as well. So I just tap on add language, and then we go and add our languages in here. So I'm going to add Espanol in here. And next thing I need to do is I need to decide what is my primary language. Well, English is my primary language. So now what I need to do is I need to set use English. If I were to tap on Spanish, it would replace it as my primary language. I don't want to do that. English is my primary language. So I select Use English, and that is telling the iPad that I'm using English as my primary language. I mentioned that we could add a second language to this. Well, actually, it'd be a third, right? English being my primary, and then we have Spanish, and now let's go and add French. To do that, again, I tap on Add Language. And then from here, I go and tap French. So I swipe up until I find French here, tap on it, and it's going to add that. Again, I need to select Use English as my primary language. So now I tap on Use English, and then it's going to update the languages. So now we can see we have our three languages here, English as my primary, and then I also have Spanish and French. So we have our languages added to the iPad. Now we are able to translate text. So let's see how we do this. Now we need to go back over to Safari. So I'm going to swipe up, and we're going to go over to Safari. The first thing we're going to look at is how we can translate an entire web page. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we just need to go to the web page that we want to translate. So I'm looking at that same web page here, Sports in Canada. I want to translate this into French. What I do is I tap on the little icon here where we have our page view options. This allows us to change the size of the text. We can add it to reader view. But now that I have those languages added, you're going to see that I have another option. What I'm able to do is translate this website. So now when I tap on this, being that I have two languages added to the iPad, I need to select which one I want to translate it to. So I'm going to go with French. I tap on French. And now what it's going to do is it's going to translate that into French. And we can see that it is translating by the icon here. This is telling you that it is in translate mode. The entire web page is translated into French here. To bring it back to your primary language, in my case, English, we just go back up to the top here, and then we just say View Original. And when I do that, it brings it back to English. Now we can also translate selected text. How do we do that? Well, basically, we just have to select the text. So what I'm going to do is just select some text in here. So we're just going to go over in this area here, and I'm just going to select some of this text. So I just long press on it. It selects it. And let's just go and select this text here. So now I have that selected. I want to translate it. Well, the way that you do that is you go to the pop-up menu that is above that selected text, and then you're going to see Translate here. If you don't see that, if that pop-up menu is a little bit short, there may be an arrow over here. You might have some more tools in there, so you might have to tap on the little arrow to get to Translate. Typically on the iPhone, this works basically the same way on the iPhone. On the iPhone, you'll have to tap on a little arrow. All right, so anyway, we just go over here to our Translate, and when I do, what it's going to do is translate that text. And now we can see that it is translated. It is translated in Spanish, so I want to translate it to French. I tap on that, and now I can go and select French, and now we can see it is translated into French, only the text that I selected. So that's how we can translate text on the iPad or Safari on the iPad. The first thing that we need to do is we need to go and add the languages to our settings. This is located under General, Settings, General, and then Language and Region. Once you go and add your languages, then what you're able to do is open up Safari, and when you tap on the little page view icon in the address bar, what you're going to see is a new option where you can translate it. If you have multiple languages, you can select which language you want to translate to. And then, of course, you can also select text, and in the pop-up menu, you can select which language you want to translate that to, your selected text to. So that is how we translate text with Safari on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, and you can share it with your friends and family. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. I have a lot more videos on danstutorials.com than I do on YouTube. In addition to that, when you go over to danstutorials.com, you can help support my efforts by becoming a member of the site. It is a membership-based site. When you become a member, what I do is I take out all of the ads of the videos, so you don't see any ads. You also have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. And then, of course, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office. I turn a spare bedroom into an office or into a studio, and I record all my videos in that. I'm not part of a large organization. So when you become a member of my site, you are directly supporting my efforts. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.